the goalkeeper to send the ball out front. They do not want to waste even a second. They are in the belief that they could be taking all the 3 points in this one. Well, which is a very encouraging and positive belief as well. Massive kick that sends the ball out for a goal kick. I think out of desperation. The build-up starts from the left side with Nora Beach. But Tila Omoto then picks it up for the Leopards. Nora Beach. Well, they need to play progressively then if they are playing for time. We've got 3 minutes of added time and we've played 2 minutes already. If they really want the time to work for them, they should be bringing the ball towards the goal area. Oh, it's Paul Were. And was pushing forward, trying to find someone to partner with up front. This one's still in the field of play. Ultimately goes out for a throw-in. And well, the time has not worked for them to take the 3 points, but the Leopards have picked up 1 point from this very grueling encounter here. And the fans are sighing in relief, honestly. It's better than an outright loss, but they pick up one more point from the Nairobi City Stadium. And Luke Emile congratulates his technical bench. It's been a very, very difficult match. It could have been a championship match here. The Leopards have thrown everything into it. They've got Anthony Kimani to thank for the goal that they got in the 85th minute from the header that pulls one back for them. Nora Beach, who previously played for Tusker FC, is quick one himself to thank the club for the performance. This Ishmael Dunga's chesting and turning into goal is a masterpiece, honestly. And you have to judge it from where the ball was taken to be able to see whether it was offside or not. But from the replays, it shows it wasn't. This one, a nice hanging header by Anthony Kimani from a corner by Paul Were, who has brought new life into the team when he came in. At least made the fans have something to celebrate with in this game today. From the Nairobi City Stadium, FC Leopards take 1 point in the 1-1 draw with Tusker FC in the Tusker Kenyan Premier League.
Going by the fact that Tusker were absolutely dominant in the first half, and then of course in the second half, AFC Leopards showing that they are here to stay 1-1. And I'm joined by the man of the match. He's a young boy. This is his first year in the Kenyan Premier League. Patila Omoto, congratulations. Tell me about the game. How was it?
It was a little bit hard, but according to the instructions that we were given by the coach, I think it worked.
Tell me about yourself. It's you haven't played that much, but today you've played the 90 minutes against a team as good as Tusker. How do you rate your own performance? How was it?
I think it was good, but I can say it's all about the team. It's not because of me alone, but it's all about the team.
Especially after the loss against Chemelil, now for you guys to get a point here against the defending champions, how much of a lift is that for you guys as a team?
it's a very big lift, because with that draw coming down, I think it's a motivation to my teammates. Yeah.
And for you as a player, you must be delighted. You've settled well in the Kenyan Premier League.
Yeah, I've settled well.
All right. Thank you very much for your efforts. Do get yourself a walker. And once again, congratulations. All right, that's Patila Omolo there. He's a young boy. This is debut season in the Tusker Kenyan Premier League, but he's done really, really well. He's been named the man of the match. I'm now joined by the coach of the defending champions, Tusker FC, Robert Matano. Coach, let's talk about the game. How was the game?
It was a tough match. You know, FC lost last week, and it was hard to beat a team who lost. But lack of concentration cost us 3 points.
Coach, in the first half, you were absolutely dominant. You missed maybe 3-4 clear-cut chances. Do you think you've paid the price of that wastage?
Of course, yes. When you miss chances, don't expect to win the game. So that's why it cost us not to win this match. Yes.
Going forward, does it worry you, the fact that you've played 5 games, just won the 1 game? Are you concerned?
I'm concerned, but we'll fight on. The fight is still on, and we'll catch up. Today, the way players played first half, It was a fantastic show, but only we lost chances. So we want to improve for that one. At least next match, we have to recover from that.
All right, thank you very much, coach, and good luck in your next game. Well, that's Robert Matano there. He says what you've got to pick your chances. You've got to win. I'm now about to be joined by the AFC Leopards coach. This was his third Kenyan Premier League game. Coach, how was the game today?
I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed because we made a lot of work during the week, and we don't arrive to collect the profit of this work. Why today? But the first goal, I say in the theory before the match that the number 18, the captain, the taller player in Kenya, give always long balls from his left foot, and we let the opponent control back. He controls, he turns, he shoots his goal. It's not possible to give so much presence. We have done that certainly last Wednesday. I don't know what are here, the big party. Is it Christmas of Saint Nicolas in Belgium? But it's too much now. We give too much presence, and we miss too much opportunities. It is incredible. We build well the game. We try to play football. Unfortunately, it is not the same in each team, but I try to bring my experience, to give something to the team, to build. Have you seen the beautiful movement from the defense to the midfield to the attack, and then shot outside? It's incredible.
Coach, but are you worried about how many chances you are giving away? We saw it against Chamilel, we've seen it today. 3-4 clear-cut chances.
Yeah, my friend, I'm not on the pitch. I cannot score for my players. Have you seen how much good movements we have made, good buildings we have made there? And certainly, we have the chance, the best chances, the best opportunities in the match. But what can you do if you don't score? It is our problem. It is our bigger problem. We give opportunities to the opponent with big presence, and we miss two big opportunities. We have to be more efficiency also in defense, in the front of. It is, I think, what we have to do.
Thank you very much, coach, and good luck. Oh, well, that's Coach Luke Mael there. He says what we've got to be more efficient. We've got to make sure that we do slightly better than we've done today. Just to remind you, tomorrow we shall be back at the same stadium. This time another doubleheader, Mathare United versus Ulinzi Stars. That will be the first game, then followed by Gor Mahia versus Sony Sugar. 12-time Kenya Premier League champions against 2006 champions. That should be a crack of a match right here at the Nairobi City Stadium. But for now, that's all we've had time for, and it's goodbye from Nairobi City Stadium.